Hi there, my name is Christoan Smit, and I'm a data protection officer for Venom IT, which is a cloud and cybersecurity wholesaler.
GDPR.
And really, the more the practical side of implementing GDPR for businesses. As always with GDPR, there are some people who really know quite a lot, and some people who seem to have quite a lot to learn still. So yeah, it went well. I had some really nice conversations afterwards. All in all, I think the GDPR is a good thing.
Yeah.
It's really a positive thing. If we go back to the 1970s, cars had seat belts, but people didn't wear them. So there were accidents and people got hurt.
Yeah.
And in much the same way, good cybersecurity, the principles have been around for a long time, but it's as if a lot of people have kind of just neglected them. Now the GDPR is saying, well, buckle up. So it's a good thing, yeah. The ICO has also made it quite clear that they're not happy with any of the fear-mongering that's been going on. And it's really about helping businesses to be more cyber aware and cyber secure. The UK, over the 2016-2017 business year, UK businesses suffered £29 billion worth of losses. That is a massive amount. It's more than what Sainsbury's made in the same year, more than what BT made, Anglo American, Lufthansa. It's a long list of companies. Cybercrime is bigger than that. So each one of us sitting here, every one of the viewers, paid £904 extra during that year just to recoup those costs. So we've been punished for crimes that we didn't commit. If that makes any sense. Yeah. So cybersecurity really has to become a cultural thing. We have to think automatically about cybersecurity. And the GDPR is really enforcing that. Like an event like this is very important because this is where ideas come to light which are not necessarily shared on open networks, for instance. It's nicer to have a face-to-face conversation with someone. And especially with things like something, to give you an example, for instance, cyber ethics is something which has been kind of neglected. A lot of people are focused on cyber security, but it's at an event like this where one can discuss cyber ethics and, you know, what is the way forward with cyber ethics and things like that. Yeah. The cyber landscape has become a threat landscape. So if you take any threat landscape, like take the open sea for instance, you need special equipment, you need a good boat to traverse it. If you take desert, it's such a severe threat landscape that people just don't go there. So unless we can actually tie all these things together and make everything secure and smooth and harmonious, the cyber landscape could become such a harsh threat landscape that it might actually become unusable. So it's really, really important. People might, in fact, go back to notepads and big pens just to avoid the dangers of the cyber world. So, which means we're at the cusp of a very exciting event horizon. There are some amazing things in the works. We've got things like quantum computing,
yeah.
Which is, it's within our reach. We will see it within our lifetime. It's really exciting. But at the same time, there's that tiny bit of a caution that will need to be exercised. And bringing everything together and at an event like this with all the different people from different industries mingling and talking about it in a very nice, open, relaxed way, I believe that's the way forward, yeah. Very good conversations.